And my next question would be to General Magalong. And I state, end quote, the President exercise his prerogative to deal directly with Napeñas instead of officer in charge of the PNP, Police Deputy Director General Leonardo Espina. While the President has the prerogative to deal directly with any of the subordinates, the app of dealing with the Peñas instead of OIC PNP Espina bypassed the established PNP chain of command. Under the manual for PNP fundamental doctrine, the chain of command runs upward and downward. Such manual requires the commander to discharge his responsibilities through a chain of command. My first question, General Magalong, is the chain of command runs upward and downward.
Tama po kayo, sir.
At sino ang kasama dito sa chain of command upward and downward?
Sir, according to the PNP fundamental doctrine, the chain of command starts from the chief Philippine National Police. But since we have a suspended chief PNP, it starts with the officer in charge, Your Honor.
So the President is not included?
No, Your Honor. He's not included
ganyan
in the fundamental
mo,
doctrine.
Kahit na ang Pangulo ay alam yung operations.
Very specific po, Your Honor, yung aming PNP fundamental doctrine. It states that the chain of command starts with the officer in charge, with the chief PNP po.
Tama bang sabihin na yung inyong manual ng PNP applies only to the members of the Philippine National Police?
Yes, Your Honor.
As a matter of fact, yan ang dahilan kung bakit in the event that there will be a violation of your manual, the severest penalty which you can provide would only be dismissal from service.
Not necessarily, Your Honor. We just would like to clarify that there is no substitution of the chain of command in our rules and regulation. There is no such thing as violation of the chain of command in our rules and regulations. But if we're talking in the context of the issue that was raised a while ago by Congresswoman De Jesus of Gabriela, which is in the context of some sort of disobedience, yun na po yun. Depending on the gravity of the offense, I would say again, depending on the gravity of the offense, it would either be or it would be the penalties would be suspension, demotion, or dismissal po.
Medyo I got a little bit confused. Sa inyong finding na Peñas did not follow the chain of command. Is that correct?
That is a statement of fact po.
Yes, a statement of fact. Because he did not inform General Espina.
Yes, Your Honor.
For that failure of General Peñas to inform General Espina, meron ba siyang action in violation of your PNP manual?
Yes, Your Honor.
Unang-una, anong kanyang infraction?
Sir, are you asking me as member of the BOI o kaya sir as the Philippine National Police?
Whatever capacity you can answer. As a general, as a policeman, as a resource person, as chairman of the BOI.
That would be neglect of duty, sir.
Neglect of duty.
Yes.
Okay. So very clear tayo rito.
Yes, Your Honor.
The PNP chain of command applies only to PNP personnel.
Yes, Your Honor.
Excluding civilian persons like the DILG, the undersecretaries, and even the president.
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you very much for that information. Sa hearing din natin kahapon at kanina, that means 1 minute, ay sinabi natin, it was brought out na mapa binigay ng Amerika. Yung finger ni Marwan, binigay din natin sa FBI authorities. At the time of the operation, merong isang Caucasian na nagbigay ng order sa AFP. Meron ding mga Amerikano sa inyong station. My question will be to the DFA. With these instances involving the participation of the Americans, will there be a violation of the Philippines as a sovereign state together with the violations of our constitution and also other our internal laws. DFA.
DFA, kindly answer that question.
Good afternoon. Sir, with respect to the issue here at hand, we have not determined any violation of any Philippine constitutional provision. I can only defer to what the Secretary of Justice has already said, that everything is within the bounds of the Constitution. All the U.S. participation is covered by Lim versus Executive Secretary insofar as the Supreme Court is concerned, and these are underneath the MDT and BFA treaties. So that is our position, sir.
So no violation?
None.
And therefore, the act of our policemen, General Navenas, na nakikipag-usap sa mga Amerikano, humihingi ng plano at binibigyan naman sila, that is not a violation of any provision of the Constitution, and as a matter of fact, it is in accordance with the existing treaties of the Philippines with the United States and other foreign governments.
Your Honor, yes.
Okay. Thank you very much for that information.
Thank you very much, Congressman Barzaga.